Hey guys, I'm here with you. Today it is on the Hot Toys Movie Masterpiece Series
256DO7,
aka the Diecast Ducky, also free armor from Iron Man 1.
I love the packaging initially that when it first came out because Bunny,
I want to say, was like $60.
Ducky
was
around $40. I like this whole kind of treatment that goes off there.
I can't justify that price.
Nice little kind of plastic overlook. I really schematics. You go in the back, and here's where you want these two.
You can find them on eBay for like $25 to $30.
And the sculptors and painters.
I want to go through all of my favorite Hot Toys for the pair of them
and compare.
Like way,
because some of them have
better.
Really good face sculpts.
Great,
some of them are
not great enough to justify.
So this one, the head sculptor is by Kojin. The head painter is J.C. Hung.
I want to compare and see if.
So before I open them up, let me show
the packaging really quick.
It is almost identical
because the face of this is really good.
They are set up as if they are
carnival
display prizes.
That comes off there.
Adventurer.
You can take that off. Authenticity somewhere there. I've not tried to find it.
And again, like I just. I really did this.
I know the Iron Patriot had a very similar treatment.
There's the back.
I just think it's a really cool way to package your figures.
Not bad
packaging. Comes off there.
But it's going in the
And there's
trash.
Everything inside, including stuff.
Up. Here you have
that's
Bunny.
Falling out because
and
you're not meant
Ducky
to open
now.
It that way.
Bunny actually has hardened plastic discs in his feet, so he stands.
There's everything included.
You get your figure.
Really well Ducky.
You get
alternate
kind of
might need to balance on Bunny.
Hey, you know what? His face sculpt.
He's doing okay. His feet might have enough
that I will get to in a bit.
And enough.
But here is your Mark III armor.
Foot of it, maybe he
at a box
can hold himself
and
up.
Just
so cool.
One thing that is worth noting,
I love it.
And it's
I don't know if this is a popular
really
opinion or what, but
I was like, what is this?
I like the earlier armors so much
Bunny
more than the later ones. I like when they actually look like there's a person
now,
inside
the
armor.
The
slicker
tag,
it gets, like,
so the
nano part
of
packaging
stuff,
material, remove all packaging material before giving to a child.
This, I think, is my favorite MCU
to the movie.
This is what I think of when I think of Iron Man.
I love it.
So, before I get to the accessories, the basic
is supposed to be there in all the artwork
has a lot of heft to it.
I never had the previous Mark III. I've only had the diecast, but comparing this to the Armored Unleashed Mark II,
to keep that.
The
so
weight, I want to say this is like
this one is
twice as heavy. That may be wrong. I haven't
this
personally weighed them next to each other.
One
but this
so
guy just,
they are different.
This feels like a pretty
go ahead and
figure.
Cut this little tag bit off.
Such a minor
good.
Thing to include.
I guess we'll start with the articulation. Like, I'm trying to decide what's
so
the angle to go with this, but I guess I'll do
really
the articulation.
The one thing I like
this is
about
one
the Iron
where
Man figures over
unless
the other Hot Toys
really
you have
like
a lot more
the
range
other,
of motion.
Figures that have actual fabric clothing,
you have to get both
limited
of them together because
you're
going to
tear the fabric.
You can
whereas this guy, you've got
better.
Full range of movement in the arms.
Because like
you
can
join their hands,
each have a
little
Velcro
at the bicep.
So if you wanted to, you
double hinge have them together.
It goes pretty far.
Be sure you consult
an option.
The instruction
holds
manual,
pretty
it does
well.
Show you that
you actually
there
have it hanging up somewhere if that's what not surpass
you want to do.
Did I memorize that?
That is a nice little feature that you can have to replicate.
So we're just going to wing it
together thing,
but,
or take them apart.
That's where his elbow can move. I mean, it's
in
got all this up there.
How they
I like how the armor
the
can move around it, so it's not going
to
really get in the way of anything.
Ear is
the wrist, 16
isn't a ball joint.
In the movie,
really have movement in and out. If it doesn't,
Woody's
it's
head
like
was about
very, very subtle.
Head. I don't have Woody's stand
he
handy.
Switch out his
I
hands
can play without
to
it,
the
but
articulated
see,
set. You can see
he's
the fingers.
A hair shorter
they move
than Bunny's ear.
He does come.
I don't know if that's accurate
fist
or not.
I think they scale
in a bit,
well enough together.
Buzz,
I have
got a nice
degree of movement.
Show Ducky. Sitting down,
I just prefer having these
he was shorter than Buzz, so I feel like if you put
them
together, Ducky should be a little bit
you
taller.
Go up to the head.
But again, it's not enough to really.
It does
really
have kind of a ball
me.
Joint at the neck area,
because
so
why not
get some added movement there?
Lots of
your main range of
show,
movement is
how he
from
fits,
the upper neck.
Do,
there's a ball joint up in there,
have lots of,
and you can get some decent movement there.
So yeah,
you kind of see how the bottom piece moves a little bit.
Oh God.
Some of my Iron Man, I can't get him in a decent flat position. The head just can't go that high. So I'm really glad this guy came. You can actually get him flying.
Disconnect him real quick.
So there's that.
Ducky's batteries go inside.
No waist movements.
Bunny's batteries
for
go inside
a reason.
One of his feet. You can see
the
plastic. The
legs.
That
these little flaps
about.
Do open
and,
up. So
I don't
keep that in mind
understand.
Before you start moving the legs around.
Why
they can go
a
pretty far forward.
That's just for the locking clips for his feet.
A little bit back, they kind of start bending outwards.
See, but
they are on ball joints.
They have 50
a very slight
each,
degree of movement
so
up there.
Hits,
they can swing out about that far. You can rotate
I'm not
going
to go through
at the thigh area.
I'm really not. If you guys really want me to,
I didn't
think
he had double hinged knees, and I was kind of let down.
And we'll just
but
go
the
back
bottom
and
was just kind of stuck.
I
so you have this
phrases
top hinge there,
and
then
the batteries
bottom hinge there. So you can get his legs going pretty nicely far
aren't
back.
Randomized, and it kind of
comes
handy
like
for a certain
pose later.
In sync, they can talk to each other. I haven't
been nothing rotates down there. His ankles do have
Bunny
worn back
movement.
These little flaps do open to help
responding to
posing him, and the toes can of course move.
I wish
we're
going to
get that
in this
video
go
a little further back.
I'm just
going
to go back
to get
forth,
them
and we'll
any
see,
further than that. And
see
I
what happens.
I just wish
so,
you could angle
go ahead
back.
I think
a little,
squeeze his belly.
Just a little didn't realize life outside of the game could be
And yeah, I mean, he's got a great amount of articulation, kind of what you would expect from a Hot Toys Iron Man figure.
Go back and forth.
As I said, the figures that have fabric clothing, they're still very poseable, but you are limited because the fabric is going to tear if you push it too far. With this guy, yes, if you move a limb past a certain point, the socket will pop off the ball. That's an easy thing to fix. I haven't had any issues with pieces, you know, looking like they're going to break. He holds a pose very, very well. As I have been just the most generic pose ever, because I
slick at posing.
When it comes to his accessories, he's got what you would expect. As I mentioned, I have the articulated hands on him already. He does come with the clenched fists. He has an additional hand that has him firing a repulsor blast. This is, as much as I love it, the articulated hands, one issue I do have is you can't really get him in a decent blasting position, and the hands just come off just like that. The way these are sculpted, and I'll leave that on for a little bit.
It could also be it's meant so that you can reply to them.
You can see, like, you can actually get them in a decent blasting pose.
But I feel like with these being as expensive as they are, there has to be some way to get them in sync. So
we're leave that back on there just for now.
That might just be wishful thinking.
It does come with a set of each of those. One thing that I have noticed is that I bought this guy, and I kept him in packaging for, like, 6-7 years. It looks like at some point the plastic kind of took out some of the paint that was on these hands, especially. I don't know how well that's going to really come through, but if you compare, you know, the glossy red of this to the kind of slightly more bland and pale of that, that is one thing to consider. If you keep them in box, the plastic protective sheets on them may at some point start to rub off or absorb the paint on the figure. So just keep that in mind. It comes with a set of these countermeasure deployers. These were deployed his flares in the first one. I'll switch this out in a second. We have forearm rockets that we can pop on. We have shoulder-mounted rocket launchers that we can pop on. I say rocket missile launchers.
Oh,
I don't know the preferred term. But to do those, the easiest is the shoulder. These are held on magnetically, so you just pop one off. Take this one. It's going to fit right into there. There you go. And these are articulated, so you can have them angled where you want them to. You go down to his forearms. These little pieces come right off. And again, you can see some nice little detail inside. I really do like when they have kind of inner bits of the armor visible. Those are going to fit right on to there. It's kind of a tight fit. You can have him getting ready to blast someone. And lastly, these guys are kind of the trickiest. You got to kind of work your nail in and just pop them out, really. There's no easy way that I can see to do it aside from just pop your nail in and then pop them out. There we go. So there's that. And we're going to put that one onto there, just like that. And that's how that looks. You can see the little flare launchers. There's that. And there's that. Of course, you can't have an Iron Man figure, at least a Hot Toys.
And yeah, I mean, that's really
without including an alternate faceplateless head.
They are just
and
plush animals.
This is a really, really
I really
good
like
sculpt.
The
now, granted,
the
you don't have to worry about the hair. You just got to do the face.
I remember seeing
you
a lot
the face
on Carnival Toys,
set, and I
you
really
can't take
think
Ducky's hair
that
and style
just like
you
Robert
want.
Downey Jr.
I mean, we miss it the more it's
I love the kind of glaze.
Overall, they look really good.
Look like
I hate that they have to throw these tags on
really good. The faceplate fits on magnetically.
It's a whole safety thing and leave
pop
thing.
That onto there.
I totally get that.
You can just take
that. Tag by law.
That slides up onto there.
Oh no!
That can pop down a little bit, so you can have that display going.
It just makes it a little
and
less.
One
accurate.
Minor.
Here's the back of Bunny.
Thing that tickles
these little
me
loops
you
are
can,
what
hold them to the packaging. So that's
Iron
there.
Man talk with
but yeah, they look really good. I absolutely love that you can have them
Velcro
switching
together.
The helmets
so
out,
you want to have
it's very easy. Just give it a little tug.
It is
on a ball joint.
They can support
this
you
one I have not put on
well.
A lot, so it kind of
on,
I kind of got to force it on. But there we go. Easy
and yeah,
enough.
That's
all
that
I can really say for
that,
these guys. If you do
want
to track them down,
and there you
I'm
go.
I'm really, really glad that they are going for cheap
great overall sculpt.
With
the
previous
Toy Story collections,
if you've missed out,
the last accessory
is the point now where it's not worth
looks a little weird
because they
gonna be honest,
up in value
it's this
so
guy
much.
Right here. So
it looks like this whole way
is as far
Ducky
as I can
Bunny,
tell
Bo,
meant to replicate
Boom,
the ground
I think.
Pound. I don't think it has any other
they're
purpose
not
outside
heavily
of that.
Inflated.
These
but
guys
it
are
is there.
Retail.
So
I
as I put that on,
it's about half what she's.
We're gonna have to take off is a chest piece.
Numbered my head.
That you have to kind of work it loose from the back. It's got a little clip back there.
I have no idea
whether or not these are for you. If you're a Toy Story collection completionist, obviously. You probably
that can
have
come
these.
Off
if you really
and then
like
that's going to
pull
this
whole piece off.
The most
and you need to pull this
of
off
the
to
franchise.
Switch out.
I certainly enjoyed it. I like these guys.
The section there. And again, I love seeing all the mind if you are an adult fuck, you want the most accurate.
If you go through,
funny,
like,
sure
you have all of these
little
additional panels
like I said,
and flaps that come off
very easily. By
as
just,
far as his air flaps go,
I thank you all for watching. If you've made it this far,
stick a little bit
more. You can subscribe to the channel at the top. There's
a little
button. Soon as I post new content, I've got two other producers on the side there. And down below, I have a Patreon and a YouTube.
You got that one.
Behind the scenes looks.
You got Twitch back here. These little guys open up.
I hope you have a great day, and I will see
you
around.
Here, and
you
got these little pieces that pop open.
It is on the
here,
Toy Story
then that
collection.
Comes up, that can flip up.
Bunny.
And
Toy
so
Story
these
4.
Are his air flaps. These little metal pieces can flip down too. Some of the hinges
Toy
kind
Story
of
4.
Stick on them.
So
I haven't.
I did
had a lot of luck with
my
Armored Unleashed
came out
Mark II.
Bunny,
some of them
they just
like don't
bucks,
move. And
Ducky was around
that's
43,
fine. That's okay. I don't have this display very often, but you can see just
price.
How far his
I
air
really,
flaps
really
can actually
can't.
Open up.
The good news is
and,
if you
kind of replicate,
two,
you know, him
you can find
pulling
them on eBay
the
for
air
like 25 to 30 bucks.
You also go down
I
here.
I think I paid
and these can pop
50
open
to 60 for the
and,
pair of them.
Just kind of show the
like
inner
way,
armature of
way
of the armor.
They're great, but they're not great enough to justify $60.
If that wasn't there, if that was just a solid piece, I would not complain.
So before
but
I open them up, let me show you the packaging
gotta,
really, really quick. It is almost identical
in terms of like what you can
they
see
are set
visible
up as if they are carnival
underneath
display
the actual.
They give, of course, this Star Adventurer.
Like,
they do have a certificate
red,
of authenticity somewhere.
Red,
I have not tried to find
but
it.
But anyway,
Target
so,
exclusive. 50 frames.
I mentioned this.
For each of them.
You got to pull it off.
You
have a button.
There's the back.
That's
how they look
right
together. And yeah,
here.
Not
so,
bad packaging.
It's kind of tricky to do, at least on camera. But you're gonna push.
Up and up. Here we have
a spine, and that's gonna let you take off
now.
Bunny actually has
yeah,
hardened plastic
the legs down there
in his feet, so he stands.
And then there's one
really
higher
well,
up,
Ducky,
he
right in
got
here.
A position. He might need to balance.
And that's
going to
let
Bunny,
you pull
like,
off.
Hey, you know what? He's,
this
he's doing okay.
Lower
his feet
part
might have enough
of,
weight
of his torso
and enough.
Now you can take this guy
level foot.
That's
going to
fit
just, yeah,
onto.
He can hold himself up. So that's cool.
Down.
One thing that is worth
nope,
noting, and it's a detail that I really
yes.
didn't expect. I was like,
what is
this?
Right over there.
It is accurate.
And that's going to go right
Bunny
into there.
Hook
and yes, it looks like
him.
Tony has snapped
now,
his spine.
The,
it looks like it, but
since it's plastic,
that allows
part of
you
packaging material,
to replicate
all
the ground pound. Now,
child.
I'm going to do this off camera
to the movie
because
random glue on his ear.
I struggle with it, as I struggle with many things in life.
So we're
going
to
do this off camera,
so
we're not
hook is supposed
time
to be there.
And
to
all
the
artwork
for Bunny.
Well, maybe not
there.
Perfect.
Certificate.
That's curious about
about
that.
As
good as I can get
part
it,
part
at least for the time being.
So you're supposed
but,
to, well, supposed to keep that.
Yeah,
so
yeah. Like, would I have it displayed like this all the time? No, no. But that little piece there really does help. When you're opposing his legs,
they are different.
Be careful of the flaps.
So go ahead
make sure
cut
the flaps
little,
are tagged
these
off. Little,
that's
I say
a minor
flaps.
Thing to include,
these little
but
pieces
I,
are up.
I love that
you start going too crazy.
So these guys
you don't
look
snap these,
really good
but,
together.
That's how he looks doing.
This is one where
my unless
honestly,
you
really,
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 so
really
far,
liked one over the other, which
I think it looks good.
I can't see
I
how
I like it. You have to get both of them together because they just look good.
You can have Ducky stand a little bit better.
There it is.
Because like button, I mean, you can join their hands. They each have
a little Velcro
here.
Piece.
So there's that button.
So if you wanted to, you could
give a good
just
tug,
have them together.
And there's that.
And
go
that's
ahead.
An option.
And,
the Velcro holds
that
pretty
one.
Well.
You
can
push it
as hard as
you
can because
what you,
I don't want to risk breaking that clip.
Do.
Just
but,
dig
it
in.
That
there you
can
go.
Can replicate
their
whole little
joint together.
Or take them apart. It's up to you.
And you know, I just realized as I was putting it back together, I left out
Bunny from
a step that I thought was required for the ground pound.
And
he has an added articulation,
what I recall.
At the bottom of his spine, there's this little button
stand handy.
I keep him to keep both out his
legs.
So he can lean
he's
forward, and I feel like that would actually help the ground pound even more.
Ear.
You can get him angled a lot better.
I don't
better.
Know if that's accurate or not.
I totally
I
think
forgot
that, that was there, and I think
but
it serves
no idea.
The
one picture I saw
pound.
Showed,
I see that being
Ducky
useful for any other
sitting down
pose,
and he was shorter than
Bunny.
So
pushing
I feel like
it back
together,
Ducky should
keep in mind you need to push this button in, otherwise it's
not
going to
lock
in place.
Bother me?
I thought
there
great
is that
because why not? Here's.
There's lots
and there
of,
he is.
Just to show how
not
he
really an accessory,
do,
but he does come with a stand.
Kind of going to fall backwards.
Looks
so, yeah,
very
nice.
Your,
I'm a little annoyed at the inconsistency between all the Iron Man Hot Toy stands.
The whole time now.
Some of them
now
are like
really
this, where
they're
circular,
they've got
features.
So many, on them.
Some of them are kind of this generic kind of.
Ducky's batteries
polygon,
go inside
I'm
of his butt.
A polygon, but whatever.
Bunny's batteries
and then
go inside
even
one
then,
of his
there's a change between
that
these.
I, that I talked about.
At some point,
and,
they took out
I
a lot of features.
These
initially did light up.
Why there's a B?
This one actually does light up.
For his feet, I,
from 2012.
It's not a button that
some
I
of them
see, but,
they've kind of filled in the
they
screw with like a little plug now.
Each,
they took out the power switch.
And they're just generic stands.
We have some, like the Mark One, that have this really kind of deluxe
really
space. Not.
If you guys really want me to, I'll do an.
It doesn't really look great
them.
When you have all these just go side back by and side. Forth. I may want to just buy some blank stands and put them all inside. I want to have consistency.
Two
but the stand does do a decent job. Aren't randomized, and it kind of feels like
it does what's supposed to.
In sync,
put the armor on there, clip it in place.
Yet there's a lot of things where
it does have a light up feature.
And then hit his button again, and it's like he's
there.
Responding to Ducky's answer to.
Not sure you can really see that lit up.
I don't think we're gonna get that in this video.
There's how that
but,
looks. It's a
very
I'm just gonna
faint
go back and forth.
Maybe
we'll
my batteries are old. I don't know.
See what happens.
If you do want to have him kind of more in a flying pose, it is possible. I don't know how recommended it is. Make sure you have this thing as tight as possible. This rod is die-cast, and it can hold his weight pretty well up top. I mean, it. It holds, but you're only getting him off the ground just the slightest bit, so I don't know if that's really something more to your liking. I didn't even know these things move. I had no idea. But anyway, the stand's okay. You don't really need it, but obviously if you have this guy really high off the ground, you're going to want to use it. The last feature to show off for him is his light-up display. He's got light-up features, and he's just a beautiful, beautiful man. He does come with batteries, but... If you're buying this guy brand new, you may want to be prepared. You may want to buy new batteries. I think half of his were dead when I got him out of the box. But he's going to come with 9 LR621 batteries that are going to be for three in each forearm for his hands, and then 3 in the helmet to light up his eyes. And he's going to have 3 LR936 batteries that will power up his chest. You want to put those in.
It's meant so
simple enough. Go behind his biceps.
The
spot there. You got a spot
but
there.
I feel like with these things,
this is the part of the spine
where
you put that
there
in.
There has to be some
and then
way
you open his face plates,
talking to each other.
And that's where you're going to put the last one.
That
so
might just be what
let's go ahead and light them up.
But, you got to switch
maybe it's just there.
So you're supposed to answer their question.
I have no idea. That's on all the way. There we go. You're onto his back. This air flap is going to have a switch underneath.
No way.
It's a nice arc reactor. Okay. My brain just stopped working. And I'm going to put on one of his repulsor hands.
Let's go look for Ducky.
Just to make it a little better.
You and that. Me, we make a
put that onto team. There. And then on his biceps, you have that little switch. And there you go. There is your Iron Man. Ready to go. Looking great.
What was that? Can't watch them go by, though. Little...
I say, like, I'm not, I suck at posing. Don't give me hot toys.
But I can't
pose them. And I think that's really all that I can say for this guy. I got mine initially through Sideshow Collectibles. I recommend using them for any of your hot toys needs. The payment plan option was something that I used very, very often when I was buying hot toys. They don't have this guy in stock. Obviously, he's pretty old. I think there's a diecast version of the Mark 7 coming out. Either it's already out or it's coming out soon. But they got a bunch of Iron Man and Hot Toys. You can check them out. And plus, it's an affiliate link, so I get a slight commission if you do buy something. So it does help out the channel. I'm going to put him there. Here we got the Mark 2. And I'm not sure how well it's really going to show. But, I'm
going to do a couple more.
So sorry. Let's see. His angles have gotten a little bit loose over the years. Let's just put him, get him standing upright. Let's get him where he's not blinding all of you. That would be great.
Speaking of Bunny, have you seen him?
Let's just get him angled. There.
Hello? Over here.
Just don't want to blind you.
I'm Bunny.
The one thing I don't want to do. I feel like the sculpts between the two are possibly identical. I can't tell if one's bigger than the other or slimmer than the other. They look the same to me.
They are just plush animals.
It's just... one change
really
that they
the
did
make. Having their eyes
go ahead
have that kind of that
effect.
If you look there,
I remember seeing
you can
a lot
see
on Carnival Toys.
The actual LED
you can
bulbs
take
behind
his face
and style it however you want.
And it's not a problem. It didn't really bother me
overall,
before.
They look really good. I hate that they have to throw these tags
this
on them.
Guy, they put a layer of plastic
it. It's a whole
in front
thing,
of the bulbs to
thing.
Kind of
I totally get that. Do not remove the tag.
And it actually makes the faceplate eyes light up a lot more consistently.
Just makes
it
a
looks
little less
really
accurate.
Good, and seeing how that looks,
Bunny,
these little loops are what hold
wanna,
into the packaging. So that's there.
Want to try to find some
but
way
yeah,
to put
look
one
really
inside
good.
The Mark II helmet.
I absolutely love that you can have them
the
Velcro
can
together.
Come
so
off.
If you want to have them hanging up either. Somewhere,
and last but not least,
here's the Mark
One
who
each other's
his ankles have gotten so bad over the years. He's been on a stand this whole time,
and yeah, that's all that I can really say for these guys. If you do want to track them down.
But these guys really all look great together. I'm glad they're going
for cheaper on eBay.
I really need to find a Mark IV. The previous Mark IV is the one that I'm missing for my Hall of Armor display.
The point now where I want to have just the Mark I to Mark VI.
Because they've gone
if I can get my hands on a Mark IV, I'll be set.
It looks like these guys all look great together. Bunny,
I really do love them.
The Iron Man Hot Toys are certainly among my favorite. These guys are cheaper than retail.
And they're just, I want to say Bo goes about half what she used.
I want to say she was $100.
I want to find the Mark III now. eBay or in collector forms is your best bet. I don't know what he cost when he initially came out.
Whether or not these are around for you,
if you're a Toy Story collection, you can find them on eBay as low as $350. Sometimes around $4.
If you really like Toy Story 4,
obviously if you want him now, he's out there for $700, $800. Those are probably still sealed. Some have ended recently for around $350.
I say they're worth getting.
He's not too hard to find.
And I don't feel like he is worth it. I mean, really is my favorite of the MCU armors.
And it's just I can see that being pulled out very easily.
But I have certainly rambled long enough.
I think if you're watching, made it this far, guys and gals,
if you like this video and you want to see more,
you can subscribe to the channel at the top. Hit the little bell so you know if I post new content.
I've got two of my previous videos on the side there and down below. I have a Patreon. I have a Patreon. I've got a lot of things behind the scenes
looks, occasional bloopers, and our Discord server.
I hope you have a great day,
and I will see you around. Take care.